When I was working for education, it was impossible. I used to complain in 1989, 90, 2000, 2001, 2002. But then in 2001, we decided to organize a long march across India, involving politicians and the people and children and teachers. All teachers' organizations of the country supported us. And it was Bharat Yatra, Siksha Yatra. It started from Kanyakumari, the southernmost tip of India, went to Kashmir and a zigzag manner. We took 6 months marching in all nooks and corners, all places in the country, and reached Delhi with one single demand: change India's constitution. Amend India's constitution and bring it to the fundamental right, because it was already there since 1950. It was the part of directive principles of state policy, but was not the fundamental right. 163 parliament members stood up in our favor. I personally met about 300-400 parliament members from both the houses. Every morning, my first job was to go and talk. Every evening, my first job was to go with the children also, the group of children. Many parliament members from all across, all parties, not just one party, agreed that we should do something. And eventually, India has seen the amendment in its constitution. The education had become fundamental right. I did not make a big noise about it, but I'm sharing with you now as an answer that sometimes the anger is also transformative and positive. Many people, or most people, did not know that who are the people behind such successes. I have very limited resource, I said, and I want to spend all my resources, 100% of my time and energy, my mind, in the night, in the morning, for my cause, not to make my publicity. But unfortunately or fortunately, this Nobel Prize has got a different limelight. People started considering me a celebrity. And there are some boxers actually this morning trying to protect me, and I was so embarrassed to see the boxers on the motorbike. God save me. And I want to ease myself saying, because the two gentlemen were sitting, one was really VIP, and that was Chris. So I said, there is a film, Hindi film. There is a man, Chris, he jumps and do every possible thing. Chris, huh? This is an English character also, like Chris. What is the name? Spider-Man, yeah, Spider-Man. He's bigger than the Spider-Man. So why I need the boxers around me? So, but it helps. The very first day I said that I dedicate this prize to all the children in the world and to my fellow citizens. Because whatever I am today, it's because of those children. I have never did any mercy to them. I have never done anything for them. And I'm very honest in saying it. I said, and I believed all my life, that they are doing mercy to me, because they still have the quest for freedom. Their parents still have quest for freedom for their children. They have chosen me, a symbol of hope for them. And that's why they came to me, and they have done a great obligation and mercy to me. I have not done anything to them. So I do it like that. I will keep on doing it. Finally, I have been talking a couple of times that when we are thinking of a sustainable development in India or worldwide, we are facing many challenges. But I have been talking of 7E. Yesterday I was talking of 3D formula, the dream, discover, and do. And today I'm talking of 7E, to democratize and make development sustainable. The first E is education. Education is key to empowerment. Education is key to sustainability. Education is a right which is key to rest of the rights of life and society. Education is key to social justice. It's key to so many things. But the key is not given in the hands of all the people in the world. Every sixth person, almost every sixth person, cannot read and write. So many children are out of the school. We cannot think without education for any kind of economic justice as well. We live in the age of knowledge economy. And if children are denied education now, they are denied their future, they are denied all opportunities to be a partner in this economic world. $18 billion additional money is needed to educate all our children in the world. That is not a big deal if the governments are committed with political will, if all of us are committed as businessmen, as civil society organizations. It's not a big deal. But when we talk of education, education has to be quality education. It is not just reading and writing skills. More clear indicators, more clear curricula, more clear efforts, more investment in providing facilities to these children so that education becomes inclusive, quality, and equitable. Otherwise, we will be creating the gaps in the society only and mainly through education. Some children must be working to make the chair for whole of their life, and we call it education. And some of us are prepared with education to sit on the chair. We will also call it education. So we have to make inclusive, quality, and equitable education for all children available in the world. The second thing is employability. How we can get rid of the traditional mindset of education systems. And what is the value? What is the purpose of education? Unleashing the unlimited potential is one thing. Making someone more responsible citizen is another thing. Opening the mind to become the global citizen and connect with the rest of the world is third objective. That is, these are the fundamental philosophies. But beside that, education should also enhance employability, which is the big issue. The third issue is entrepreneurship. I need not to say anything because we are in the middle of what we call the valley of entrepreneurship, Deshpandeji? Yes, the valley of entrepreneurship. So we are here. So that is equally important in for the sustainable development and inclusive democratic development. And the next thing is the efficiency. We have to build efficiency in all walks of life, in our skills. Skills should be more quality and more efficient. Our outcome should be driven by the efficiency at all levels in employment, in entrepreneurship, and everything. And then comes equity. If we are creating a world which has layers and layers and gaps and unimaginable distances, social distances, economic distances, cultural distances, then we cannot connect the people. So we have to think of equity in life. And then environment. We cannot ignore all these challenges of climate change and global warming. So protection of ecology and environment. So ecology an issue. And the last but the most important E is ethics, the morals. Sometimes the political leadership graphs go up and sometimes go down. We change the leaders and we try to fill that vacuum in a democratic world. Sometimes the financial, the economic graph go down, come up. We all face these economic crises in the past and now repairing and some aftermath and so on. I need not to speak. But when the moral graph goes down in our life, it's very, very hard to bring it back to the level and bring it up. We need ethics and morality in our day-to-day life, personal life, in social life. We need morals in religions and religious institutions. We have to be working for an ethical, moral politics, moral and ethical business. In every sphere of life, what is lacking now and declining now is the core element which is the key for survival of humanity, and that is ethics, that is morals. Those values are declining. So we have to work hard to bring it back, and that is possible. That is possible. And that's why I always say that let us begin with our children. For years and years, we kept on teaching them. We taught them you are Hindus. We taught them you are Muslims. You are Christians. You are great. Son of Jesus. Son of Ram, Krishna. Son of whatever. Sikh, Buddha. We teach them high caste, low caste, as I said before. We teach them that you are Americans, you are Indians, you are Africans, you are superior because you are born in America. If you are born in Pakistan or Afghanistan, oh, we are suspicious about you. These kind of things we teach to our children right from their childhood. Let us try to take a U-turn for a while. Yesterday, a young lady who was here, she said that she was in one of the lead programs. And she attended it, and she said that I was with a group of children, and for a few hours I felt that I was a child. It's my last minute. I'm sorry. Should I say sorry to all of you? But I'll say sorry to the organizers. I know that I can keep on talking and you keep on listening, but this is not fair. I agree. So, let us learn from the children. Let us learn. Sometimes we spend some time and sit and see and watch the children carefully in the schools, in neighborhoods, in our homes. And then we can learn many things. We can learn simplicity. We can learn transparency. We can learn to be very straightforward in our things, not to be diplomatic and be artificial in our behavior. We get rid of artificiality. We learn how to learn, the quest for learning. The desire for learning is always there in the children. We can learn that from them. We can learn many things. We can learn forgiveness, which is needed in the world today. Nobody wants to forgive. We are making a very, very, very intolerant world. The biggest disaster or biggest crisis which I see in the coming years is intolerance. So let us learn from the children. And need not to go outside. If you want to come back to yourself, if you are simple, if you are humble, if you are having the forgiveness, transparency, it's not because you are a big, rich businessman. You have accomplished a lot of things in your life and you are so educated and PhDs and social workers or whatever, politicians. It is because a child is inside you. Each one of you and me, each one of us, has a child inside us. And that's why, we are compassionate. That's why we have some simplicity. That's why we wanted to move forward and take the world in our hands. It's because a child is inside us. So, I appeal all of you, please, 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 listen to that child. Don't let him die inside you. Listen, please, listen. While you are praying, while you are doing your business, while you are doing your politics, whatever you are doing, please, please listen to that child inside you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.